The views and opinions of this broadcast do not reflect the views and opinions of Studio 6 Entertainment, Armed Media, or the Entertainment Partners LLC. Enjoy the show.
Interrupting your regularly scheduled program to bring you this terrifying report.
You're about to listen to Night Talk, so buckle up. Your host tonight, Joe Rocks, now on Spreaker every Thursday, 1 a.m. Eastern.
I had a good cold bottles, but I didn't have any warm beer. I had warm beer. No cold.
Hang on, I'm doing an intro. I'm doing an intro. Hold on.
Oh,
I gotta get a good chair.
I know. It's like too loud. Chair sucks. They're too loud for some reason. Yeah, mine's not going.
I don't make any fucking money around this shit.
You don't need any money.
You and your friggin' pocketbooks.
Hey, hey, purses.
Thank you and welcome to that wild intro. Put my new mic, my new headset on. Wow, that's loud, isn't it? Loud?
Yeah, I just told you that. Oh, shut it off.
Shut up. Hey, welcome everybody to Night Talk. You can't hear me?
Shut me off.
I didn't shut you off. How about that?
Stop it.
What? Is it too low?
Too high.
Oh, all right. Stop. Okay, how's that?
No, too much. Bring it down. You haven't a minute ago.
You just said you couldn't hear me.
Great. Bring it down.
Down?
Down.
Down. Down.
Down.
Down.
Down.
Down. Okay. We're coming in about 10 minutes late, something like that. Right?
Because of me, yeah.
Right.
Down a little bit more.
Come on. Are you serious?
Yeah. No, now it's shut off now.
It's not shut off. Yep. There you go.
There's something wrong with that switch.
No, there's nothing wrong with the switch. There's something wrong with your freaking ear.
No.
Anyway, welcome.
I can't hear you.
Huh? How can you? You're sitting right next to me.
I'll take the headphones off.
I can see.
Just turn it up a touch. No.
Yeah. All right.
No, down.
Okay. Anyway, welcome everybody to Night Talk. There's nothing wrong with the switch. Tonight, on Phoenix the Coach.
Good evening, everybody.
Yeah, he came in a little late because, what happened, your car broke down or something?
No, I was getting you some beverages.
Oh, thank you for that. Appreciate that.
I had warm beer at home. I said, I can't drink your warm beer.
No, definitely not. No.
Ran at the corner and got some nice cold, nice and cold.
Yeah, these are not cold ones. Thank you for that. Appreciate that.
What?
Why do you wear shorts like that?
Like what?
You should, when you go out, you got to be like more, you know, dressed up. Do you know what I'm saying?
Wait, these are $100 shorts.
Oh, they are?
Yeah.
All right. I didn't know that. Dude.
Man, what do you wear? You wear underwear to the mailbox.
Well, that's a different deal. But anyway, welcome everybody to Night Talk. Tonight, we're going to discuss a few things that are going to come to our mind. If anything comes to our mind.
If anything at all. Yeah.
Oh, speak about mind. You know, I hear these commercials on the radio a lot and, not the radio, but the television a lot about that thing, Alexa, you know?
Yes.
Okay. So, you know, Alexa, get me a coffee, do this, do that, you know, that type of thing.
I've heard that.
But they can't, that's a little machine, right?
Right. It's a little robot machine.
Yeah, it's a little robot. And so, but you know, that kind of thing is making, you know, people, I think, lazy. Do you know what I mean?
Everything today makes people lazy. Everything.
Yeah, I know, but I'm just, you know, I'm kind of like.
No, I mean, that's. But they were talking tonight on the news and stuff that before you know it, robots going to be doing everything.
Well,
everything.
You know, I'm speaking about robots. Alexa is what we're going to talk about for a minute.
Yeah.
Armed Radio is going to be on Alexa. So in other words, if you have Alexa, all you have to say is, Alexa,
Armed Radio.
Turn on Armed Radio, and we'll pop right up. Well, that will be coming in probably on Monday or Tuesday of next week.
That quick?
Yeah. Wow, that's awesome. So I got the word today.
That's awesome.
When I got home, and so that's pretty interesting.
Yes, very. It is.
But I don't have an Alexa, so I'm gonna have to buy one just to try it out. You know what I'm saying?
I'm not gonna try it until you try it.
What is it, like a Bluetooth thing?
I believe so. Yeah.
Yeah, something.
A lot of people have it.
Yeah,
it's
all you do is ask it questions.
Yeah, Alexa, what's the weather in New Hampshire? Alexa, what's all kinds of crap?
So it's like Google, kind of.
Yeah, exactly.
Oh, okay. So I didn't know that, but yeah. So that'll be all for the gang. So when the shows are on, you don't have to even get up. I'll just do Alexa. I'm radio. That's it. Boom. Bang. You know that's pretty cool. Would you like to meet my guest back there? That's Lynn. Lynn is from Malta, the island of Malta, which is off the coast of Italy. She's very easy to look at. Don't you think so? Can you see her?
No, your head's in the way.
Oh, I'm in the way. It's my head, man.
There you go. That's okay. That's
okay. So she's fairly easy to look at.
Yeah.
It's just so. And the good thing about having Lynn with me, or with us, is that she can babble on and we don't have to listen to her. We could just look at her, right?
Well, I mean, I like to hear the voice. I like to put the voice with the face.
She has kind of an accent. Do you know what I mean? I'm like,
that's kind of hot.
Yeah. That's my,
it's kind of hot.
Yeah. She's done a lot of stuff for me.
Okay.
Yeah. It's good to be with her tonight.
Yeah.
You know, virtually.
Even though we can't hear her, but yeah.
Well,
Alexa.
No.
Oh.
No. I mean, if we can hear her, then, it's a different deal. But, we can't, really, hear her.
Ask Alexa if we can hear her.
We can't. But let me just do this, for a minute. I got to, share all my stuff. But in the meantime, why don't you talk for a little while? What are you up to this weekend?
Well, this weekend, not a heck of a lot. I got a graduation party Sunday.
Mm-hmm.
Today's Thursday, Friday. Friday, I'll probably take it easy, sit by the pool.
Yep.
Have a few beverages and, clean up and probably head out for the night. Now this single life is pretty good,
Uh-huh.
And like I said, Sunday I have a graduation party to go to. But today I did a job today. I was the outside super on the job.
Yeah, yeah.
And
you're on the trades this morning.
Yeah, I'm in the trades. Yeah. And
yeah.
That was the outside super. The job wouldn't have gotten done without me.
That's correct. That's correct.
The job would not have gotten done without me.
That's correct.
I keep the men laughing.
You do. You keep everything light. That's pretty awesome. But yeah. So I mean, I don't know what I'm doing. I mean, there's so many things going on. I don't
know. I see that.
Yeah. Look at this. We got 73 new people in this week.
I saw that. Yeah.
That's pretty good.
What's that? 105,435. I see.
Yeah. That's amazing.
That's a few people.
Yeah, that's a few people.
We're on a roll.
Yeah, we're on a roll. But anyway.
We had, I'll give a little bit of the weather report.
Let's have a useless weather report.
Yeah. Well, I mean, useless. We lost power here. This is some serious business.
Hi, Catherine. How are you? Hi, Catherine. Come on the show, Catherine, sometime. I don't think, Catherine's in, Taiwan or someplace like that.
Oh.
Yeah.
Well, come on the show.
Yeah, come on and drop in joerockslive.com. If anybody wants to stop in joerockslive.com, we're on till 11 o'clock tonight on Armed Radio, and then the replays are on Spreaker, so you can catch us over there, on Spreaker after in a while. But so basically, we do this stuff every week pretty much, right?
Same stuff, shooting from the hip.
Yeah.
Shooting from the hip.
Yeah. But go ahead, I'm sorry.
I know. I mean, you got to say hi. But it was a wild Monday or Tuesday.
Yeah.
Trees down, electricity out.
Right.
And apparently you had some problems with your generator.
Yep.
I know my generator was under your window again, so.
Right. Yeah, I was inhaling all your fumes.
You couldn't sleep.
No, I couldn't. I couldn't sleep. I couldn't do anything.
And inhale all the fumes.
I couldn't sleep right now either. Do you know what I mean? Like, you know, if you think about it.
Well, like I said, it was, they closed the street down. When is our street been closed down? Not since I've been here. I've been here 18 years.
I know. Well, Catherine was here. I was going to ask if she can hear us, but it's too late.
She's gone?
Yeah, she just pops in and says hello and goodbye. Because I think it's late over there. I think
I see it now. Catherine Chin. Hello, Joe.
Yeah. So.
That was nice. That was nice.
Very nice.
Touch base with us.
Yeah. Stop in, say hello. Right. I like that. I like people like that. You know what I mean? That type of thing. But it was a wild, wild week for weather.
I mean, 90 degrees, right? Mm-hmm. It went to the 90s. Actually, it almost hit 100, didn't it?
Mm-hmm.
It was like 98, 99.
Yeah.
And then the next day we get these winds knocking trees over
we get
hit very hard.
We did.
There was actually a tornado touchdown and somewhere up in the mountains. A hiker actually sent pictures of it.
Really?
Yeah. It was. They said it only touched down ground for like 30 seconds.
And can you hear me eating potato chips?
No.
Can anybody? If you can hear me eating potato chips, you can call me at 1-800-508-5431 and let me know if you can hear me.
And we'll share them. And we'll share them.
Well, I don't know. Because we're doing a radio show, right?
Yeah.
We're not doing a TV show.
Right. So we can share the chips.
Yeah. So anyway, and chips are good with beer.
Salt. It's the salt.
Oh, is that what it is?
Yeah. Oh, yeah. It's the salt. All these bar rooms, you know, is to give peanuts mm-hmm. or popcorn.
Yeah, that's right.
Popcorn. And it's loaded with salt, you know.
Ah.
They load them with salt. Yeah. Mm. Like you said, they're good. You hit the nail on the head. And you're mostly a wine drinker.
I am.
But you're drinking beer, you know what you're doing. You said, yeah, because the salt, you know, goes good with the beer.
Yeah, it makes a, you know. When you drink beer or any kind of, you know, stuff, and you have something salty, you retain water.
Yes.
Yep. Yeah. So
that's why you're always yelling at me with the salt thing.
Right. You do use a lot of salt. You know, in all fairness.
Yeah, but all fairness, you know.
Well, I'm just saying.
I like my salt, I guess, you know. Now we had a conversation today, I think, about Alaskan king crab legs.
Yep.
And it was a shrimp. It was a shrimp that you liked, didn't like it cold. No, that was the bodyguard.
Yeah, yeah.
That was the bodyguard.
Yeah, yeah.
How about yourself?
I like our shrimp cold.
Okay. Shrimp cocktail, naturally.
Yeah, naturally.
And I make a nice salad with shrimp in it, by the way.
I've never had a salad with shrimp.
Well, it's a macaroni salad.
Oh,
macaroni, scallions.
No, that doesn't even sound good.
Oh, it's good. It's good
really?
Stuff. People throw people every time I go somewhere, ask me to make it for the party.
They do?
Yeah.
All right, let's go somewhere sometime. And I want it, as soon as we walk in, they're going to ask you to make it.
Well, I'll make it. I don't know what the restaurants will make it.
I'm not hip on macaroni salad.
But you, I am. Love it.
Well, you like Alfredo sauce too, so that's
yes. Yeah. Yes, that's right. Yeah, we talked about that today.
Yeah, I'm not like I'm not like that kind of thing. You know what I'm saying? It doesn't sound good.
Yeah, I like the seafood Alfredo with the scallops and the shrimp.
Really?
And to die for.
I don't know.
To die for, my friend.
Hmm. Hmm.
You're a meat guy.
No, I like meat, but I mean I like chicken and stuff like that. I like macaroni. I like all that stuff.
Yeah. Well, macaroni salad, same thing.
No, I don't like macaroni salad. Macaroni salad is like an American thing, and I'm not. You know, it's
just, you're not American.
I'm American, but it's not. It's not like something that.
Not you.
It's not me. Basically, it's just not me. You know, so I just I'm not crazy about it. That's all. It's not crazy about it. You know,
I usually make it a lot, like I said, in the summer. Something quick, you know.
Yeah. Macaroni salad, same thing. No, I don't like Yeah.
Where are we? What happened?
Oh, no, I just fixed it. So, you know.
This one's always behind.
No, it's not behind. It's like, I just fixed it so we can see, you know, what's up. You know what I'm saying? That's all.
Okay.
Know? Yeah. But, yeah, so, yeah, I'm not crazy about that kind of stuff that you like. Do you know what I'm saying?
And what's your take on this this border watch with these kids and being taken from the parents and so on and so forth? And
yeah, I mean, what's my take on it?
Yeah, it's getting pretty nasty.
Yeah, my take on it is my take on the border thing. Well, here's my take on the border thing. I think that they shouldn't come here.
No, I mean,
I mean, they shouldn't come here. I mean, they just shouldn't come here. People don't, I'm going to tell you something. Okay. You know, I'm going to tell you something.
Yeah.
And we don't like to talk about politics. Okay. So, we have another show on here on the station. Okay. That has a group. And it seems like the more that the president is getting bashed, the higher the numbers that are joining this group. I mean, and I'm talking about maybe between 15 to 25 a day is coming into the group, you know, because I know because I'm an admin. And so I get all the alerts.
Yeah.
It's I don't know. I don't know what's going on.
Yeah, I don't either. That's why I'm asking you, how much you know about it.
No, I don't know. I don't know too much. I mean,
I'm sure they make it look worse than it is. It's the media. The media ruins everything.
Right, right.
The media ruins everything.
Yeah, so. That's true. You know, I don't know. Yeah.
You don't know what to believe.
I know.
That's the biggest problem. You don't know what to believe.
I know. I don't
know. Or who to believe, you know?
Right. Well, if you do have a salad tonight, right? I mean, tomorrow, use that stuff from...
fire salad. Yeah.
Newbridge. Yeah.
I hid that.
What, you did?
Yeah.
Right.
Tonight, when I brought it home, that's good stuff. They'll taste that. They'll take the whole thing off me.
That's true, yeah.
All right?
Yeah, that's true.
They'll take that. That's excellent. Mm. Excellent. That's the same stuff we had.
Today.
Yeah.
That was good. Good stuff.
Very good.
Yeah. So, yeah, that's my take on that. My take is...
You don't know who to believe, what to believe.
Yeah. No, I know not to believe, you know, that kind of stuff over there. You know what I'm saying? But, you know, you don't know what to believe, right? You know, who to believe in. You know,
right.
I don't really follow Paul. I mean, I do follow politics.
No, I'm like you. I dabble in it, but that's about it, you know?
You know, I mean, I can tell you, though, that because I've been around for a while, in the past – So many months or a year,
yeah.
People are spending money, a lot.
Yeah.
I mean, a lot of money.
And actually, they're actually talking about the unemployment rate, like 0%.
Right,
it's going. Yeah.
Yeah. A lot of people are getting off SSI.
Yep. Well, I hear you.
You know, I mean, it's just like, wow. You know, but we'll see what happens. I really don't know. You know, I really don't know.
No, it's all you can do is, I guess, take it one day at a time, see what happens.
Yeah.
I know the gas prices and propane and stuff like that are ridiculous.
Yeah.
That's insane. Yeah,
that's true. That's
I
true.
Ordered some propane. Oh, I didn't order it because I wasn't going to pay that kind of money they were asking for.
Yeah.
What do you laughing at?
Yeah, I mean, I have beer affects me like in a different way. Do you know what I'm saying?
You've only had a half a bottle.
I know, but I don't drink beer that much.
Yeah?
It just affects me in a different way. Wine is a little more, makes me mellow a little bit. You know what I'm saying?
You drink vodka at all?
I do. I drink vodka. But, I mean, I don't really drink a lot of vodka.
Yeah.
You know,
what's your vodka of choice?
The Goose. The Goose. I drink the Goose. But, I mean, I don't really, I don't really drink a lot.
Right. Right.
You know, I'm not, I don't come home and have a beer.
One or two, done, two and out.
Yeah, no, I don't really drink like that. You know what I'm saying? If I go out to dinner or something like that, I'll have a drink or two.
Right. That's the same. Two and out.
Yeah, but I mean, I don't come home and have a drink or stuff like that. Like some years ago, they used to have martinis, or something like that when you come home, or scotch or whatever, so I don't do that.
No, that's not, how about scotch? You like scotch?
I would like to try it, Scotch.
Oh, so you're like me. They say if you acquire a taste for Scotch, it's like the best.
Yeah.
That's the scuttlebutt.
Yeah. So, you know, I did go out one time in town and, you know, this, you know, I said, I'll buy you a drink, right? So, the guy's name was Vinny, right? And he says, you know something? He says, Joe, I said, I can never afford it. He says, by the way, I really like to try, Cuddy.
Cuddy, yeah.
Cuddy Sock, yeah. Right? Black. I think it was Black. I'm not sure.
Yeah.
No, Doers. Was it Doers? I'm not sure. Well,
Doers is Scotch also.
Yeah, Doers. I think it was Doers. And
could have been. Yeah.
Yeah. And so I said, yeah, whatever. Yeah, no problem. So they brought over the drink, and what they did is they tipped the glass upside down, and they put steam in the glass, right?
Oh, I've never seen that.
Yeah, they steamed the glass, and then they dumped the Doers in the glass. Okay. And I guess as the steam is rising, you're supposed to smell it and stuff like that.
I never heard of that.
But when you're drinking that, or you're supposed to sip it. That's not something you should.
No. That's not, you don't
shoot that. That's a sipping thing. I might like to try that sometime, maybe, you know. I mean, it doesn't go with food, though, does it? I mean,
I wouldn't.
Just to sit at a bar.
It's
that's like a bar drink. You just sit there and
sip on.
Yeah, just sip. Yeah, you just sip on it and you stay like. But he really liked it. I mean, it was good. But that's the whole idea, is they turn this glass. I forget, it's a special glass. It's like a, you know.
I never seen that.
Yeah, and tip it upside down, and they steam it, and it gets all like misty, and then they pour it in there, and that's it. Boom. That's it.
I never heard of it.
Yeah, that was it. We had that at Jimmy's when it was on the waterfront. That was years ago. Jimmy's years ago. I don't know if you remember that.
Yes, I do.
Jimmy's, yeah.
I'm not that old, but I remember.
Yeah, we must have read it in
books. We were young. Yeah. We were young bucks.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
At the time, but I like yourself, I've drank in Boston, you know, and had some cocktails, but one of my most experience that I remember is this bartender girl, and she made a B-52,
mm-hmm.
which is Kahlua, Bailey's, and Grand Marnier.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
And she put the, she, I was amazed. She took the glass, the shot glass, put it on her forehead, pushed her head back, and she poured the three alcohols into that glass without spilling a drop.
Really?
On her forehead. That was amazing. I couldn't believe it.
Well, I mean, would you do a shot off somebody's stomach?
That's a good question.
I don't think I would.
That's a good question.
I don't think I would.
And some of them shots actually go down the back too, right down the cheeks.
Yeah, I wouldn't do that.
Right
either.
Down the cheeks. Nah, I have heard of that. I haven't seen it.
Yeah, I've seen it down in Florida. They do that in Florida. The
yeah, it's a Florida top, thing.
Yeah, they lie.
Yes, that's right. Yeah,
they
that's
lie
right.
on top of the bars and they.
Yes.
And you can, you know, they pour the you know
down the belly.
Yeah, yeah,
down and the down the cheeks.
Yeah, and then you. You can drink it. I mean, and you're drinking and you're getting like, you know, lint from the stomach and stuff like that. You know, all that bullshit. You know what I mean? I mean, you know.
Oh, yeah.
It's like, God, I don't know, man. I don't know. Oh, yeah, Janelle. J. Monique. You know, will be coming on at some point. She sent me a little note. And so she'll be coming on.
Oh, okay.
To stop by
tonight.
No, not tonight. She's not coming tonight. She's doing her own thing. But
okay.
Jay, I've known Jay for a while now. She's a great person. Great person.
Okay.
But anyway, yeah, I mean the drinks, I mean, you know, I've seen a lot of those different things down in Florida. They do that.
Oh yeah. Florida's big for that. Yeah.
Yeah, they do that.
Florida's huge for that. Yeah.
Yeah. It's you know. Think about Florida, though. You gotta have a lot of money to live there.
Yeah.
You know, unless, you know, I mean, because, you know, I mean.
I mean, how is housing nowadays?
Well, I mean, the housing is probably reasonable, but, it's not reasonable because people just go there to die there, right?
They call it God's waiting room.
Yeah,
right?
I mean, yeah. You just go there and you just pick it. Just sit there, basically.
God's waiting room.
You don't do anything. You go golfing, maybe, or...
No, can't even do that anymore. Shoulder's gone. Can't golf.
Yeah, you can't golf. I mean, you know, they don't go to the beach because they're older. They don't want to ruin their skin.
Basically. Yeah, I mean, like that. They're all wrinkled
God.
I mean, didn't was it you and I talking about this? Or somebody said that an alligator ate some lady? Did you hear that?
No.
Yeah. No. Alligator ate some lady.
Really?
And I guess they got the gator, cut it open. They found part of the body in him and stuff.
Really? What was that?
And that was in Florida. I don't know exactly where, but
wow.
It was in Florida. And
is that recent?
Yeah, just I heard in the news, I don't know, like 2 weeks ago, maybe.
Wow, that's fucked up.
A couple weeks ago. And I didn't realize this. Maybe you know a little bit about it, but I guess they haven't found the rest of the body. Mm-hmm. A gator will take their prey because they don't eat a lot,
right?
And stash it somewhere.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know how true that is, but that's what I'm told.
They bury it underground or something.
In the swamp, and you know they put it somewhere in a swamp and stuff.
But
some lady was walking her dog, and I don't know exactly how it came about, but the gator got her.
Really, boy! Oh, is it, you like my shirt, Coach?
I saw that. Yeah.
Maybe. You know, I had Facebook, you know.
Yeah.
So
you have?
No, I had. You know, that means
I love Facebook.
I like Facebook or something. I don't know.
I love Facebook. Yeah. Hot is love.
Whatever. Okay. But I'm making a fashion statement tonight, basically. I just shot the whole beard down.
Yeah.
What do you call the beer when you they punch a hole in the top and then what do they call it?
I forget. That's a big thing in Florida too.
Yeah,
that's a big thing.
They do that too.
They stab a hole in the bottom.
Yeah,
and they chug the beer.
Yeah, they got to drink
the whole thing.
Yeah,
yeah.
I can never do that.
No, and you know I'm a beer drinker, but I can't do that.
You could do that.
No.
They couldn't do this to the glass.
No, it's a can. That's a can thing. They can take it and smash the bottom if they want, and eat the glass.
Yeah, but they couldn't do it. They couldn't do it for in the glass though.
Not at all.
So that would be funny as hell though. I mean, you know. Not funny, but
these spring breaks are ridiculous, unbelievable.
Yeah,
it's just kids, and good for them. Don't get me wrong; as long as nobody gets hurt,
right?
But they're just crazy and wild,
right?
You know.
Yeah. Now you must have been wild when you was younger.
No.
Would you homebody? Do you like to stay home?
You mean like when I was single?
Yeah, when you was, you know, a teenager.
Teenager, yeah. I grew up in the country.
Oh, yeah.
I grew up in the country. You grew up in the city. I grew up in the country.
Yeah.
We there was like six houses in my whole neighborhood.
Really?
And everybody had big families, too.
Yeah.
I never got to the city until I started working in the city, you know?
No,
but I hate going to Logan Airport. That is ridiculous.
Well, you know I don't fly, so it doesn't matter. You know I'll
really
go to.
You don't fly.
I don't fly. I don't want to fly. I don't have no. I have
really.
No,
you've never flown.
No, I've flown other ways, but not in the air. Let's put it that way.
Okay,
if that makes any sense.
Yeah, it makes a lot of sense.
All right.
Have you ever flown in an airplane?
No.
Wow. I didn't actually until I was 33 years old.
That was the first time I did. Oh, well, you know, the thing about me is I like to drive a lot. I mean, I enjoy driving. Some people just don't enjoy driving, but
no, I don't.
I think when
I hate driving.
Well, I mean, when you're driving, it's when you go on a vacation or when you're driving, that's the whole idea of having a lot of fun. You know, it's
no, I hear what you're saying.
You know, airport, going to an airport, you hop on a plane, you just get off. It's just like, it's a little different thing. I mean, if you're in a rush, maybe that's
business.
Try a plane.
A business trip.
Something like that.
No, that's true. But if you get time on your hands,
But I mean, to go on vacation, I mean, you know, or something like that,
you're right. Driving's the way to go.
Yeah,
if you get the time,
right. If you get the time,
I mean, you can stop and see so many things.
Right. So Florida would take 2 days, basically. You know,
at least.
Yeah, 2 days to get there. It's 1,500 miles. So we do about 750. You know.
Yeah.
So that's basically what. But I mean, and then you know, I mean. You know, I mean, that's really not that bad if you think about
No, there's a lot of places you can stop on the way down there.
A lot of things you can see that you would not normally see and stuff like that. You know what I mean?
But if, like you say, you know, if you're on vacation for a week, you definitely want to fly. You want to get there.
Right.
3 hours you're there, you know, and you're at your hotel, timeshare. Whatever.
Not really. You're at the airport in 3 hours. You got to take all that in consideration.
Exactly, and you're exactly right. And that's why, you know, 7 days is not enough for a week's vacation. You lose, you're right, you lose a day trip there,
right,
and a day you leave.
Right.
So you gotta at least probably do 10 days is my thought.
Yeah, 10 days, I would say.
10 days minimum, you know.
Yeah,
because you lose a day going there. Like, you're right. You lose a day going there, and you lose a day coming back.
Yeah,
because
those 2 days, they're going there and they're coming back.
They're gone.
Those days.
You're in the airport. You're getting luggage. You're getting your rent a car.
Yeah.
Whatever.
Yeah. It's all gone. It's a mess. But yeah, like I say, I'm not really crazy about flying. I mean, I just don't do it. You know, I don't. You know.
Well, you went to Florida what, last year, the year before, a couple of years ago?
Yeah, something like that.
Drove down?
Yeah. So, yeah, it typically takes about 2 days, you know.
Yeah.
I mean,
you can do it in 24, but it's crazy.
Yeah. Yeah, I've done it in 24 hours. That's kind of like shithouse. You know what I mean? You're like a zombie when you get down there.
But I'm sure, like me.
When I was
younger. You were young.
Oh, yeah, when I was younger.
You could do that in a heartbeat.
Yeah.
I mean, we used to take a van, and my cousin had a van. He had, you know, nice van, and it was like four or five of us would go during spring break and stuff.
Yeah,
and we'd each take turns driving. So that day it works.
That's another thing. I can't sleep if somebody's driving.
Oh, really?
No.
Mm-mm. Wow.
No. Mm-mm. No. I could never sleep if somebody's driving. It just bothers me.
Keeps you up.
It keeps me up. It just keeps me awake. It's just like, you know, if they slow down, it's like, oh, you know, that type of thing, you know, because I feel, you know, so I can't really relax when somebody else is driving, you know. It's just a different, I mean, I've drove so much that, people don't really, you know, they just, I don't know. It's just, I drive a lot. So, I
hate driving.
I know what you mean, but I mean, it's just, you know, I'm just saying like, you know, whatever, you know, that type of thing. You know,
I'm not a fan of driving.
Yeah, yeah.
Well, first of all, I can't see.
So I got to tell you a story about this guy, right? I'm not gonna mention any names, he hasn't had his license for a while.
Okay.
Right. And the thing is now, you know, I mean, I think it was like he has lost his license for like, I don't know, 8 years, 10 years, something like that. A long time. And to make a long story short, you know, they awarded him back his license again.
Okay.
Right. And he can drive after he pays a fine, whatever the fine is. I think it's like $2,500, something like that type of thing. But he has to blow into his car. He has to blow it. Yep. He basically has to give his car a head, if you know what I'm saying. Like when he gets in the car, he has to blow into some kind of thing, right? But, you know, if you, that's for drinking, but he doesn't drink. So what the fuck good is that thing? You know what I'm saying?
I mean, was it put into effect because he was a drinker? Or
I have no idea.
You know what I'm saying?
I don't know his background, but that's what I've heard. I've heard it through the grapevine, you know, that type of thing. I don't really.
I mean, you could be an ex-drinker. You don't know. So.
Maybe. I really don't know. You know, I mean, I don't know. I don't really know. But, you know, right. I mean, I don't know. That's going to be pretty bad when you lose your license that long.
I know a guy, same scenario, he got his license back and stuff, but all he had was a motorcycle. So what do you put this thing you're blowing?
Oh, that's right. I never thought about that. You can't put a blow thing on your motorcycle. I never thought about that. Yeah, that's unbelievable. Yeah,
so I says, wait a minute now.
That's unbelievable. I never thought about that.
I says, how do you, you know, of course, most people have a car also.
Well, and, yeah. Some people,
this,
yeah.
This kid was a little weird. You
really?
Know?
Yeah, yeah.
So, yeah, he had a motorcycle and where do you put a, you know.
That's fucked up.
Yeah.
Yeah, I never even thought about that, to tell you the truth. That's weird. That's weird. I mean, I don't know, different strokes with different folks.
Yeah, right? But I mean, where do you put it? Like you said.
Yeah.
On the handlebars, you know?
Yeah, that's, I don't know, you know. I mean, some people, I mean, I really don't know. I mean, some people just have a personality like that. Do you know what I mean? They just, you know, I mean, they, you know, they have, you know, I mean, some people can control themselves, but, unfortunately, that stuff is not for everybody. Do you know what I'm saying?
Well, I don't think I won't be in my time and your time, but I bet you down the road you're gonna see them in every car, and you got to.
Thanks for stopping in, Randy. Appreciate that. That's Cowboy Randy. I mean, it's Cowboy Randy. He's been in so many movies and stuff like that.
I know, huh?
Songwriter Randy.
Hi, Randy.
Randall Warner. Warner. And he's got a few songs out now. Yeah. So
nice songs.
Yeah, check him out. He's on Reverb Nation, and you can also pick up one of his songs on iTunes, which is Beautiful Lady in a Black Mercedes.
Nice.
So that's
very nice song.
Yeah. Thanks for stopping in, brother. Appreciate that.
Now he's not from around here, so he's a few hours behind us, right?
He's actually in California. He's in Santa Monica.
Okay.
Yeah, so he's in Santa Monica, California. It's 3 hours. So it's probably like 7 o'clock there, something like that.
Yeah.
Something like that. So that's awesome. Good. Thanks for dropping by. But I mean, getting back to what we were saying about what were you saying?
I don't know.
No,
we get sidetracked.
Yeah, we just shoot from the hip.
Right.
Ronnie B's here. Ronnie B, give it up for Ronnie B. Sexy, Ronnie B. Okay.
Ronnie B.
Yep. So Ronnie B's here also, and he's got a chart climber. It's been getting good reviews. Drop it like it's sexy. I get a lot of feedback on that. And so good job, Ronnie B. To the both of them. They're both very, very talented guys, you know. Yeah. So I appreciate that.
Do they work together?
They do touring and things like that. Yeah. So yeah, they're always doing that type of stuff. So yeah, that's pretty cool. I mean, thanks for dropping in. Appreciate it. Yep. Randy, I've dropped it like a sexy so many times. It's like pathetic. You know what I mean? But yeah. So this is my my virtual co-host in the back. Ronnie and Randy. That's what it is right there.
She's talking, but I can't hear her.
You don't have to hear her. She's just for looking. Right.
That's why you keep me.
Yeah. Well, I mean,
I'm a looker.
Yeah. Yeah. You are a looker. but she's like that. That's great. Matter of fact, you know, I will send her a copy of this. I think she'll get a kick out of it. but to make a long story short, what was I saying now about the beer? Something about the beer?
Yeah, the beer. Well, you're saying that you're a wine guy and.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I am aware.
Yeah, and beer.
Yeah, I did like your pop-up show, Randy. Appreciate that. I want to know. Also, I've known a lot of puppets, if you know what I'm talking about. You know, those kind of puppets there. You know, well,
I hope
so. They're working on they're actually working on a concept for a series. So, you know, so
really?
Yeah, the two of them, and so they'll be good if they're, you know, I mean, yeah. They're just shopping it around right now, that type of thing.
The puppet thing.
Yeah, and so
I like to see.
What do you want? What do you want? Would you like to meet Lynn, Randy? I mean, I want to tell you, Randy, the best thing to do is go global, and that's what to do.
That's what I do.
I go global, and that's basically what it is. It's global, and that's what it is. Global, right?
Look at it. That's a nice picture right there.
Yeah. That's, I mean, it's
very nice picture. Come on,
man. Anyway, yeah. So, yeah. Oh, thanks for all those hearts. We're getting all kinds of hearts and stuff like
that. Yeah, I see that.
Appreciate that.
Is that for me or is that for you?
That's probably for you, you know.
No, I don't know. I don't know. Hmm.
Well, you are single and recently divorced.
True.
Yeah, let's hear about that. You recently divorced. I mean, have you met anybody?
I've been out playing the field.
Oh, okay. To baby steps.
Baby steps.
Gotcha. Okay.
I talk to you in the bodyguard when we go to these signings and everything.
Yeah,
and
yeah.
Baby steps.
Okay.
You don't want to jump into nothing.
I understand that. You know, you got to take your time. Take your time. You know, go easy, right? Yeah.
Gotta. You don't want to make the same mistake twice, all right?
Believe me, I know that. Mm-hmm. I know that. So yeah, so you know, Randy, you can come into Joe Rocks Live, just punch it up on your phone, and you're right there.
He knows how to do that.
Yeah, he knows how. You know,
he's done it before.
Yeah, you guys don't have to be shy. I mean,
I know, really.
I mean,
not in front of us.
Nobody watches this show anyway, so you know, I mean, what's the difference?
All we do is talk to ourselves.
Yeah, we pretty much just talk to ourselves.
You know, just like being on a construction job.
Yeah,
and just, you know, having a little
right. Yeah, we're in the trades.
Coffee break. We're in the trades.
Yeah, so that's
we're in the trades.
Yeah, so basically that's what we do. We just shoot the breeze.
I mean, a little coffee break and shoot the breeze.
Yeah, exactly.
That's all.
Randy was married three times, by the way. Congratulations. That's three times is a charm.
You know, Randy's a hat trick.
Yeah. He's a hat trick,
A hat trick.
Yeah, he's a hat trick. Well, Barry. Well, I mean, that's what happens, Randy. You know, you fall in love easy. Yeah, he's a cowboy, so that's what happens.
Well,
cowboys, you know.
Cowboys don't fall in love. They fall in lust.
Mm.
All right?
Mm-hmm.
It's lust.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
So.
I got you.
I'm not a cowboy, so.
Yeah. Well, yeah.
I only did it twice.
Yeah. Well.
There will not be a threesome. I mean, a three time.
Oh boy! I just.
What's?
But that's pretty cool. That okay. So all right. So why don't you type out your phone number, Ronnie
B.
And I'll put it on the air for you in case anybody wants to call you. About that,
they're not calling us.
It's 13358. Wow, that's a lot. Wow, 358 some odd thousand, something like that.
Wow, right.
You guys are doing a great job. That's great. Three times is not a charm. Yeah, but yeah. So basically, now what was I talking about now? Oh, Alexa.
Earlier.
So Alexa. Yeah. So Alexa, you know, we'll be on Alexa next week. Not just me. I got everybody on.
The whole gang.
The whole gang. I took the whole gang with me. So the whole gang is on Alexa next week. So if anybody has Alexa, and you know, I mean,
it's a no-brainer.
Yeah, it's a no-brainer.
Alexa.
Yeah, Alexa. You know,
I want armed
radio, and that's all you gotta say. And
boom,
and Alexa will boom right on there. That's pretty much it. You know, The coach.
That's simple.
Yeah. Ronnie B. The coach can't really see that well because he doesn't have his glasses on. Do you know he has these thick Coke bottle glasses that he usually uses?
I usually use beer bottles.
Oh, beer bottles or Coke bottles.
I use a beer bottle. Hi, buddy.
Yeah. Yeah. See. Oh, see. You get check marks. You know, like the thumbs up. You know.
Thumbs up.
Yeah. Give us some.
Thumbs up. Give us a thumbs up.
Yeah, give us a thumbs up, and then you can follow us on.
I don't understand. They know how to. They've been on before.
They're working tonight at one of the clubs, so they really can't come on because we wouldn't be able to hear them and stuff like that. And so basically, yeah. So, but yeah, I hear you. You know, but yeah, I mean, so what was I was gonna say something about too. What was I gonna say?
Well, it's I don't know. You hit me too. You know, we're losing it here a little bit.
No, I mean we're not losing it. I
am. I've lost it. Mm-hmm. I've lost it for a while now. But we talk about Alexa.
Well, speaking about losing it, when did you how old was you when you first lost it?
Lost what? My mind?
No, first time you
jerked off?
No, not jerked off. But you know, when was the first time you lost your virginity? Do men have virginities?
I don't know.
I don't think so.
I don't think. Yeah, I don't think we do.
So, how old was you?
Oh God, that's a few years ago. Wasn't in high school.
It wasn't in high school.
No, wasn't in high school.
When college?
I didn't go to college.
In the service?
I didn't go in the service.
Well, how old was you?
I'm going to guess and say I graduated 17, 18, about 18, 19.
Yeah, that's about right. 18,
19.
Yeah, that's about right.
You know, and I don't remember it.
I don't remember it.
Do you? That's good. You know what? That makes it worthwhile. If you can
no, remember. Not really. It wasn't worthwhile then.
But you remember it, so.
That's not a good idea to put your phone number on the thing. Take that phone number down, Ronnie B. You can put his phone number on. There's thousands of people that watch this thing. You know what I mean? Thousands, Ronnie.
What's Amy saying? You're gonna have Amy.
No, just put a like. There's thousands of people that watch this. Thank you. Oh, you still got it up there. Oh my God. But anyway, if anybody wants to get in touch with Ronnie B, you can or Randy, you can give me a call at 1-800-508-5431. Leave a message of who you want to deal with, and and I'll direct you to their manager, who is I don't even know who their manager is. Who's your manager now, guys? I mean, do you have one? Your manager?
I know they read it out, you know.
No. Yeah, no, but who was your manager? I think they have a manager. I don't know the manager's name. I forgot him. He's a big he's
big from
Florida. Yeah, he's a big
wig. Yeah, we're in California, right?
No, they're in California, but he's right. In Florida. The guy.
Oh, he's in Florida.
Yeah. Yeah. Randy lost his virginity at 17. You know, 17. So.
Like I said, I was probably 18,
like
19.
That. Yeah, well, like that. Yeah, but 18, yeah, well, that's basically what it is. Yeah, so that was good. I mean, yeah, wow. Anyway,
we got a lot of phone calls. We're not answering the phones.
No, we're not answering the phones, and I can't keep up. We're getting a lot of Twitter stuff.
Yeah.
You know, so
it's hard to keep track of it all.
Yeah, I can't, because we have Twitter over here, going over here,
right.
And people
Facebook
are like,
over here,
Facebook over there, and this and that.
We have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 monitors.
Yeah, I mean, I feel like I'm in CBS or something.
Yeah,
something like that. You know, it's ridiculous.
Nightline or something.
Nightline.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I mean,
yeah, Nightline.
Yeah.
Nightline. How about No Line? You know what I mean? But yeah. Oh boy, I'm telling you. Anyway, let me see. I want to test this out, Randy. So can you let me know, Randy, if you can hear this? This is a one of the one of our old intros that I'm just testing out. So can you could you do that for me? Could you let me know about it, Randy? Can you give me a friggin' thumbs up or something like that? Can you help me out a little bit? You know, could somebody help me out?
Work with me here. Yeah.
Can you work with me here? Can you help me out? I'm gonna run it.
Well, we got something.
Okay. No.
Call Joe. No. For a show.
No. Listen. Listen, guys. I'm gonna do this. I'm gonna put up a promo, and I want to see if you can. If you can.
If you guys get it.
If you get it. Hold on. Just let me know if you hear it. Hold on. I hate when this happens.
All right. Well, you know, he's got so much equipment here.
No, no, but can you? Hold on. All right.
All this equipment.
Okay. Can you hear us? Can you hear the other commercial, Ronnie or Randy? Painful. Can anybody hear it?
Anybody out there?
I mean, these guys are probably baked out of their minds.
Man, we got something going on. All right,
can you hear the radio?
Look at, we're getting all kinds of thumbs up, hearts, and everything. Look
I know, but can you hear the? Can you hear the radio? What does that mean? I don't want a heart. Just write yes or no. Oh my God! Can you hear the radio?
We don't even know if they can hear us.
What does that mean?
Thumbs up. We're getting more thumbs
no,
up.
No, just let me know if you can hear the radio. The song. Can you hear that song? Oh,
this is painful.
Yeah, that's painful. Yeah. Thank you for that. They were all baked out.
Yeah.
They're all baked.
Yeah.
They're baked. Oh, man.
You wonder why we drink, huh?
I know. You wonder why we drink. Take this out. Because I get an echo in my ear with this thing. This is, you know. Let's run on another system.
Apparently that didn't work. Yeah.
Thanks for the help. Appreciate that, guys. Anytime you need anything, let me know. Unfortunately, no. I mean, I'm right there for you 24/7. You know what I mean? I mean, it blows my mind, people.
No, yeah. Like, pin, what?
We don't what? I don't know what that means. I mean, you know, this we're on radio, Ronnie B. I mean, we can't really, definitely, you know, weed and
no.
stuff like that.
Try again.
No, I can't try again. I can't. I'm coming to the end of the show, and so, but yeah, but
we're on borrowed time right now.
Yeah,
we're on borrowed freaking time.
We are.
I know you people want to listen to us and hear us, and but
yeah, but
we're on borrowed time.
We're on borrowed time, and borrowing that time, I'm going to say one thing. Look for, you can, as of next week, I believe Monday or Tuesday at the latest, you'll be able to hear all of our shows on Alexa. So you just punch up Alexa. All you have to do is Alexa.
Yep.
You know, get me on radio and then boom, it'll be right in your face, right? So that, you know, you can lie down, you know, in your bed, whatever you want to do.
Nope.
Yeah, jerk off. Or whatever you want to do.
What do you want to do?
Yeah, Alexa, get me a cup of coffee. Yeah, yeah, that type
Alexa
of thing.
Alexa, jerk me off.
Yeah, whatever. I don't think they jerk off.
I don't know.
Really? I'm not
too. Alexa, give me head. I mean,
yeah. Well, yeah. I mean, I wouldn't have a machine with that. So, you know.
Yeah, imagine the machine with whacking.
You can't hear me.
It'd pull
hold on. You can't hear me, Ronnie B. How's that possible? I mean, is that possible? And you could just hear the coach. Now, can you hear me? What? I'm right here with But anyway, this is our show tonight. It's short and sweet.
Nice show again, as always. But Alexa, I want to see if anything can go with Alexa jerking you off.
Yeah.
Alexa.
So yeah, I'll post that.
How does that work?
I will post Alexa next week on our feed. So.
She has anything to tell us, or something.
Yeah, yeah. Well, actually, we'll do a demonstration over here. I'll get an Alexa, right? And she'll, you know, take Alexa, that type of thing. That'd be cool. Yeah, that'd be cool. Or something like that. We'll see what we can do. But anyway, guys, and Ronnie B and Randy, thank you so much for dropping in.
Thank you, as well as
Catherine, thanks for stopping by. Appreciate that. And Everybody have a great weekend, and we will see you next week. This is Coach Wyman. Add anything?
No, it's been a great show as always.
Yeah.
And we'll talk next week.
But do you want to add anything?
I just did.
No, listen.
逢每周四晚东部时间11点，与周 Rocks 一起听夜话，只在大枪武装录音首页。
Good night, everybody.